I don't know what the deal was. Like, it didn't give me an error. No.
It's weird.
It didn't give me an error.
It just
decided it was gone. Anyways. I'm here. Okay, let's finish adding this copper, and then I'll dismiss the class. I'm just adding these lines around areas that are already in the piece. I'm not making any new designs. Just outlining what is already in existence. And we're going to move this to the dust free zone, and then I have some coasters that I'm going to use the rest of my this on. I think it turned out pretty nice. Even go down that far.
No.
That's what she said.
Where's my list? I can't see any of y'all's chats. Now I can. Y'all's Amazon page tonight. You're asking about how to order from our Amazon? Absolutely, Mary Beth.
Let's do some coasters with our leftovers, because waste not, want not. Alright, let's see if this dirty pour made anything nice. I'm just going to pick up some black from the runoff and fill in those areas. Now, I wouldn't be able to just leave this much resin on there. It's way too much. So I'm going to tilt it off onto this other one. If I were to just put it in the dust-free zone with that much resin, it would all run off anyways. dark. I swear I put white in this. It's not bad at all, actually. I don't know what that texture is, but that one looks fun. We'll let that one live. Now, all the whites in this one. Covering all the raw areas. Now we're going to heat it and tilt it to see what it's going to do. There isn't a lot of that creepy green color in this. I was very concerned for a minute. Oh, it's fun looking too. Hey Petra, how are you? Yeah, Petra always does beautiful work. If you haven't checked her page out, you should. Alright, let's see what we can do with this mess. Looks like I'm just going to use it as a grease the pan. Then add some other colors to it. I like what that orange looks like when it goes over the white. I'm gonna have to explore that on another one. Sure about this one. Let it set for a minute and then we'll decide. So let's explore that chocolate orange white look. I'm using this stirrer to move the white around because I have so many other colors on my hands.
Okay.
Way too much resin for this size. Add just a little bit of black to this too. How that chocolate orange just glows. An awesome color. Judging from the cells, I could have done this without the black being added to it, but again, live and learn. I'm just rotating everything around so that my design is centralized, but not, I want it to stay organic. Know what I mean? Jelly beans. I'm loving that color. Need more of that color. Alright, let's see what we got. Let's do a smush. That is way too much resin. Chocolate orange is by Color Obsession, and it's that vibrant orange that was in the last poster we did. It's an opaque paste, and I think I only have a few of them in stock right now. I should have waited to use that color till I had more, but live and learn. For what?
Did you know that the space bar is a...
Yeah.
You didn't know that. And then to you. They say iPhone is the iPhone. It's all something that's about. I told it to him.
Love it. Look how this last one we did looks now. I don't even like working with orange. I'm digging it. Yeah, chocolate orange is the actual name of the color. This looks very Western. I'm pretty much here for it. I love all the colors, how they work together. We just have to be careful. I would not recommend these particular colors
if you like to use a lot of heat, because once they mix together, it's, as you saw earlier, it'll make a horrible, horrible green color. Thanks, Tara. It is opaque, non-metallic. Those fun cells popping up right there. Same, Karen. That's fun. I would do an entire piece if I could make it look like that. One more coasty with you guys. I guess we could do a smush. See what that turns out. Gonna do the black color passion based on everything. Hey Tia, I was just talking about a piece that you had done not too long ago with, it was black and a lighter blue and kind of an orangey sienna color and maybe a chocolate, I don't know. But anyways, I was researching a color palette to do for today, and that one kept coming up on like Pinterest feeds. You probably know exactly which one I'm talking about. I think I commented on it every time it came up in my Facebook feed too. If you guys don't follow Tia, you should. Wait, I don't know if she has a YouTube channel. I know this looks a hot mess, but just hear me out. What we got this, and we got this. Here we go. You do, but there's not a lot on there yet? Gotcha. I'm just gonna smush that so that some of it comes out of all sides. Don't want any naked parts. I always do like a quarter turn. Heat on and see what they're gonna do. I would do a whole piece like this if I thought it could would turn out that way. this bright orange color just stretch out, so I'm tilting it down this way. And I do a, I already did a larger piece with these colors. I just did that. Maybe I'll do a smush with these colors, like on a larger piece. I've been talking about doing a large scale smush. Hasn't happened yet. Love it. I'm gonna let that one live. Ooh, look how this one's turning out. Huh? You look good, except for I did something with this. I don't know what I did. How fun is that? Focus? Not focus? I think I'm gonna let this one live just like it is. Olivia says, my boy wants to try to replicate Jeff's fire piece. He loved it. So our class for November, our online class, is going to be a fire piece. So my goodness, how pretty is that? Hey, look at this piece. Look.
So.
Okay, I'm gonna do just one more smush. I know I said that was the last one, but. I'm so excited about this. My smushes never turn out that nice. This one will. Because that one did. What did I do first? I can't remember. Turquoise. And then white and chocolate, I think, was all over in that. Glad I'm out of coasters because I am now out of white. No moss. And then our lovely, lovely chocolate orange is now going to be one of the colors, and people are like, what color should I get? That's going to be on the list. A little bit of heat. Put it together and smush so that it comes out just a little bit on all of the sides. Or a lot, apparently, according to that side. Quarter turn. Let's see what we got. Okay. I'm making a huge mess. Loving it. I'm loving the way that orange glows. cells that pop up because of that color passion. I'm definitely gonna have to do a large scale smush. It's on the to-do list. Tilt that off just slightly and then pull it back. Ooh, that's an awesome idea, Clara. I'm loving them, I'm loving them, I'm loving them. Did that chocolate orange is one of my new favorite colors, although other than this palette I have no idea what I would do with it, but I'm sure I could figure out something, even if it's just like a black, white, and orange one, which would also be awesome, especially since Halloween. I hope you use the palette as inspiration to do some awesome art on your own. Can't wait to see it. If you do want us to see some of your art, please tag us in our Facebook group, ATD's Poor People. I'm not quite sure. I will check my text messages. I didn't check them yesterday because I was putting out the class kits enough, but I will check them later today. I have a lot more orders to put out before I can get to the phone. I have to do things in order or else nothing will get done. Can you do some work with micro powder? Sure. I don't use a lot of micas, but of course we do demo on demand, so I will absolutely. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you had fun. I hope you learned something, or at least were a little bit inspired or entertained in the meantime. I would love to see what you have to post. Your artwork in our group. If you would like to see any, if you'd like to use any of the things that we use today, you can find it on our website, artisttolife.com, 2 T's, 2 L's. And yeah, please like, subscribe, and share. We'll see you guys tomorrow, 6 p.m. And I think that's all. Be kind to one another. You never know what someone's going through. And I will see you guys next time. Bye. Bye.
I said bye.